We're using some new cameras today. You know.
New look, stream it. Season 7.
This is what you get when you have the unpaid. Oh, no, he's a paid intern.
Paid intern.
The unpaid intern.
That's how interns should be.
He's being paid. So, Marcos, behind the scenes. We love it.
We appreciate it. So we haven't, I don't think we've ever actually talked about musicals before, besides when we rant about Lin-Manuel Miranda.
Yeah, how did we miss that? That could have been a whole show. Like,
right?
Back in season 2. Like, right? A layup.
Way back then.
Musicals. We talked about that TV show that she hears people's thoughts in.
Oh, yes.
Zoe's Extraordinary playlist.
Yes. So we've touched on it.
But I wanted to know, what is your favorite musical movie?
Okay, before anyone answers, yours is Grease and yours is Pitch Perfect. And if I had to go number twos, your second one is Chicago and your second one is La La Land.
Wow.
Kind of spitball.
I just sound pretty basic.
I want to guess yours. Newsies.
Newsies.
Oh!
But I do love Grease. That's a classic.
Yeah.
And it's like the first
Newsies. That was a good call. But did I get one and two for you?
Yes.
Chicago's a little, I don't know.
I think the first time I saw it
was with me.
Was at your, yeah, with you at your house. So that's why.
We probably had a great time.
Yeah.
We probably had popcorn.
If you're watching a movie, there was popcorn.
Yeah, so that's probably why it was a fond memory.
So my question is, I have an adult movie in mind, but are we just like not counting Disney movies? Because like the Disney classics, like Lion King.
I would say no.
No.
Okay.
Because I probably like most Disney movies more than a lot of musicals.
Yeah.
So the one I would say is not like necessarily like a great musical you think of, but it's a movie that my dad showed me when I was little and I love, and it's The Blues Brothers.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I love that. It has like Aretha Franklin, Ray Charles, all these people singing.
Yeah. I feel like I've seen other musicals that I'm not thinking of.
Well, I mean, like White Christmas, Singing in the Rain, like those like 50s era. I mean, Wizard of Oz, those like classic movies.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like we might actually have to have, this is just a quick question, an actual show.
And like talk about them.
Because with some research, I feel like I could find some like good ones that I remember.
Yeah, I went through a list. I mean, Mamma Mia. Oh. And then Hairspray.
How could I forget?
All the High School Musicals.
Mamma Mia.
Yeah, that's like right up your alley.
Come on. What was I thinking?
It's a layup.
Moulin Rouge. Oh, Ewan McGregor and Nicole Kidman.
I love Moulin Rouge.
I haven't seen that.
It's a weird one, but the music is good.
It is. Yes, agree.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we should do a whole show on it. But yeah, I think Newsies is probably up there.
I knew it.
As well as Grease.
Grease, the first time I saw it, also with you.
Wow, we just watched musicals together.
You saw Grease kind of late.
I saw Grease in like high school.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, me too.
So maybe that's
normal. Middle high school, yeah.
Middle school, yeah. Maybe. Cool.
But yeah, late compared to the fact it came out in the 70s.
And then,
that's true.
Yeah, I mean, In the Heights was up there now.
I knew it. Couldn't resist.
Vanessa.
I love that song. I listened to it on the way to work today.
But don't... The thing about... I don't want to get into this. Maybe we can just do it on the musical thing. But In the Heights, your boy Lin-Manuel Miranda is so not in your face. He just like a Sarah Redd in those...
Except for his solo, yeah.
Yeah. He obviously is going to give himself a song. And actually, it's funny. He gave himself a post-credit reprise of the song. So it's like you're ending with him, but
not me.
Other than
I
what,
got right out of there.
Other than what,
I
didn't see it either. You know, I never end up catching the post-credit scenes.
That's true.
But Sarah called them jump scares when you saw him.
Yeah.
But other than the jump scares, it was his music and stuff. But it was other people.
Yeah,
that must have been more tolerable for you.
Mostly, I liked it, and like Moana, I think is incredible.
What about Encanto?
Doubt now.
I'll see that.
It is.
It's on Netflix.
Oh wow.
I saw it yesterday.
I thought it was a Disney movie.
Wait, it's the one where he's like that little monkey thing, right?
Oh, no. I forgot about that one.
Oh, that's what
No, the Pixar one.
Oh.
No, it's just Disney. It's not Pixar, but he's doing the whole thing and Stephanie Beatriz plays the main character.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, not that one, but there's a different one where he's the monkey.
Yeah, we looked at that. Yeah.
He was in...
Well, maybe for next week, we'll have to watch that and then...
He was in His Dark Materials, too.
So yeah.
It's not like I'm like opposed to things that he's in or a part of. And I actually do respect his, like, the good stuff that he does. But he just drives me nuts with his little, like, side cart of, like...
Piragua.
Yes. Of annoyingness. Because otherwise, he's like... Like, Moana music is awesome. I love that he collaborated. I love that the You're Welcome, the rock sang, was, like, in his style.
But so you don't...
work perfect. So yeah. I'm, like, fine with it. But when it's, like, overly done, and then he, like, is all, like, weird about it.
So, like, in the opening of In the Heights, when Usnavi's, like, introducing the characters and all that, if that was him, you would have just been, like, I'm out after this 8 minutes.
Yeah. And if... But if it was the way it is, and, like, not him as the actor...
Yeah.
And I had never seen anything from Lin-Manuel Miranda. I think I would have, like, loved it.
Right.
I would have been like, oh, look at him, like, rap talking. Like, this is wild. And, like, but now it's, like, such a thing. And he's so,
so
like,
that, to me, is, like,
goofy about it that I'm just, like, sick of his.
Although level. He's front and center in Hamilton, he plays Alexander Hamilton. You end up liking
the other people.
The other people more. You're like, his writing is great, but the performances by everyone else, you're like, they're better. Christopher Jackson's a better singer. Leslie Odom Jr. is a better singer.
I guess what he does well, I like respect him for, and I like. And then all the over the top stuff, I just wish he'd like wouldn't even involve, so that other people can do it and make it good.
He's tough to watch if you ever see clips of him on the Tonight Show, because him and Jimmy Fallon are trying to like one up over the top each other.
That sounds gross. I like Jimmy Fallon, but
you ever see the video when he first sang like the opening Hamilton song at the White House? Everyone's laughing.
I saw it like at like 4 minutes and I was like, okay.
Yeah,
he's like cringy when he's doing like the over the top stuff, but when his work comes through in like a well done way, it's amazing.
Well, I think that's the I think the new movie that's
why
coming
I don't
out
like hate him, I just don't like him.
Maybe we can at some point show the trailer, but the new one coming out is like kind of like Moana. It's a story of a
I think it's gonna be great
Colombian village with people that all have magic magic except for one person in the family, but he does like the music and stuff.
I think that's a perfect role for him.
I don't see you, it's animated.
I don't hear you, but I know that you were involved in making this good. And then thank you for that. So I feel like that pretty much hits the nail on the head with how I feel about our boy.
But I still think we should do a musical episode.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. We
would love that.
For sure.
Okay, so 2 weeks ago, we talked about what we've been watching to catch up, and then we disappeared for 2 weeks.
Summer schedule.
Yeah. So we can keep talking about what we've been watching, because I think we have actually watched more of the new stuff in our little break. So... yeah, just jump back into that.
Yeah, I can jump us in, I guess. I've been watching the Rick and Morty new season. I don't know if you guys have seen any of
that. Not the new season, no.
It's more of the same, which is excellent. Someone, was it one of you who told me there was like a, like even something that was a lot for, even for Rick and Morty?
No.
Someone said that they like almost crossed a line somewhere, and I haven't seen it yet, but I've only got like 2 or 3 left in the season, so maybe it's coming. Or maybe I just blew right past it and I was like
expecting
it. Yeah, like everything is borderline in that show.
If I got to say, if you're watching Rick and Morty and you're like, ooh, they almost crossed the line, Rick and Morty's not for you.
True.
Like,
well, that's why like I don't know who would say that about that.
A high schooler
was like something that was like, I don't even know what would be that.
A high schooler married a thing called bird person. Like, there's like, I mean, what do you expect?
I know.
Guy turns himself into a pickle.
They have hamsters that live in people's butts.
Yeah. What do you expect?
No, I know. That's what I heard. I don't know if I read it somewhere or someone told me, but maybe they were just sensitive to something. I don't know. But
don't go to Rick and Morty, South Park, or Family Guy and be like, oh, that's too much.
Yeah.
Like,
so from what I've seen, everything's been pretty on brand for Rick and Morty and like very funny, very good. So if you're a fan, get in there. I thought you think you have to watch it on like adultswim.com or whatever because it's not on HBO yet and it's not on Hulu.
Oh, okay.
But it's available.
So you have to sign in with like your
Oh, you might. Cable. I don't know. I don't remember if I did. Yeah, I think I did do that.
Okay.
So
that's easy enough.
Some hoops to jump through.
Yep.
But
username and password.
But worth it.
So tough. Well, this one I think I mentioned the first season of this before briefly, but there's a second season now. It's called Dirty John. It's on Netflix. I think it was added like a few months ago, but I just started watching the second season, and it's about Betty Broderick, who killed or was accused of killing her ex-husband and his new wife. And it like tells the story of like what led to that. Wow. And like centers on her, because the first season was about this guy John Meehan, who was like a professional like con artist and like mainly focused on like women. Like he would like marry them and then like bleed them dry.
Oof.
And they never even saw it coming. So that was really good, and that had like Connie Britton in it. She's like his last wife that he has before he gets like got.
Wow.
And then in the second season, I don't know who the woman is who plays the main character, but I forgot his name, and I know his name. It's the guy. Oh, Christian Slater. He plays like the ex-husband. Gotcha. So it's just like a true crime.
So is the second season more of the same from the first season,
or is it a different crime? Focused
completely on a different crime.
Oh.
It's the woman Betty.
And is it?
Oh.
So it's like a, it's like an American Crime Story where they have actual actors acting it out.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
And it's like telling the true story and everything.
Oh, cool.
But
nice.
Yeah.
That reminds me a little bit of the I Care a Lot.
Yes.
Is it in the same vein?
He kind of was, but like even like worse.
Oh.
Because it's like just all
that movie
parts
was pretty
alike.
Twisted. Like
yeah.
I'm like, dang.
But yeah, very similar.
Yeah, okay.
The first thing I have been watching has it is on Netflix, and it is called I Think You Should Leave.
Oh, I love that show.
It just came out with a second season. It is a 15-minute episodes skit comedy show by Tim Robinson is his name.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
And it is like I texted my brother after the first two skits, and I was like, this is perfect. He like – it's a joke, and then it seems like his shtick is every single skit he flies off the handle. He just like loses his mind, and it is so
like
fun.
Kind of like the key,
like Key and Peele, Dave Chappelle. Like,
oh, okay, yeah.
It's like different. You know, it's a different group of friends or whatever. But it is just like he goes 0 to 60 every single one, and it is so funny, and it's raunchy. It is like everything that tickles my fancy. It is so good.
It's so funny.
Oh man.
And
I've never
and he has like he has Stephen Young, like Andy Samberg. He has like people you recognize.
Nice.
And it's just
oh wow,
so
I guess
funny.
I gotta tune in.
Oh,
see, I like doing this because you get ideas of
and
what
it's
to watch
15 minutes, so you just like put it on and you're like it's 6 episodes or something.
Yeah.
You like watch the whole thing. You're like, what was that? That was so funny.
So you finished the first season?
Yeah.
The Garfield sketch. I
oh
don't know why.
God.
It was my favorite.
So there's a second season?
It yeah. just came out.
Oh, nice.
Yes. That and The Greatest Baby in the World.
Oh, yes.
That killed me. It's so good. Sorry.
Yeah, it sounds really funny, guys.
Yeah. I'd love to be a part of one of those someday. Yeah.
Oh, you'd really like it. Though.
I will tune in. That's what this is all about. And for you at home. Is that your that was
I
your
mean, one? I could go again. I have like a list of like 5 or 6 things.
All right. Well, we can just rotate.
Yeah.
Here. So I don't know how old this is, but I think there's a new season coming out, and that's why we started watching it. But I was watching the first season of The Great. It's on Hulu.
I've seen a couple episodes.
It's like Catherine the Great, but it's like based loosely off of whatever that
it's
story.
A satire.
Yeah. And it's like supposed to be kind of making fun of like a royal family and like a court and everyone lives in the palace and the whole thing. And
yeah.
Basically, the wife is trying to have like like have a coup of the like monarchy. So her husband, and she's kind of plotting to try to figure out how to do that because he's very old school and she wants like modern.
Yeah, spoiler alert from the 15th century. Catherine the Great becomes Catherine the Great and becomes
right.
a queen.
So, but this is like how I guess it happens. Yeah. Based loosely. Mm-hmm. But it's like funny. It's one of like a, I don't know.
The guy that
it's a
plays
dramedy, I guess.
Beast in the like newer X-Men movies
yeah.
is her husband.
And he's just like an off the handle, raunchy, like everyone loves me.
Oh. Yeah.
Like pompous, like king, but he's like
Who
young.
Plays Catherine. She's Elle Fanning.
Elle Fanning. Or,
I know what show you're talking about.
I think you would like it because it's like kind of a drama, but it's got the like, I don't know, an edge to it that's kind of funny.
Ooh, okay. I didn't know that's what it was about.
Yeah,
for a while, it was like the flagship show. It would like
on
always
Hulu,
be
yeah.
the first one.
Oh, yeah. I kind of have seen it before in the past like that too, and I was like, oh, whatever. But then I actually sat and watched it because... like I heard it was good and it's like pretty interesting. So, so I guess that's the one. There's another season coming out. So now's a good time to watch the first one.
I'm gonna have to watch it.
So
this
I got a couple episodes left.
Working.
But yeah. There you go. More. Yeah. More for you at home.
All right. Well I have two that I know we've all seen, so I guess I'll save those. I watched the movie Good on Paper. On Netflix that came out maybe a month ago.
Oh, I think I've seen something
it
about
has
that.
The comedian Nicole, her last name is something like complicated to say. She's like blonde, that you would know her face if
yeah.
you saw. And it's this like dumb comedy about this guy that she meets that it's like based on a true story for her, where she meets this guy and he's like good on paper. He's perfect.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But then like she like slowly starts to realize things of like, oh wait, I don't like know this about you. Like it's kind of weird. I don't know this about you. And then like keeps unraveling and is like, wait, I don't know you at all. And like, you know, like he's like what he's presenting to her is not who he is.
Right, right, right. I think I watched this. I'm trying to remember now. That
it
sounds
was, like,
so familiar.
Really dumb.
I can't remember now.
Is it a comedy?
Yeah. And she wrote it, so it's like a comedian wrote a comedy, so it's like ridiculous.
Oh, yeah. I got to look it up because I can't remember if I've seen it or not.
Yeah.
Sometimes you just put on like a Netflix like show or movie and you kind of not
yeah.
fully tuned in.
It was like a really good, like, I had nothing to watch and I was like, oh,
yeah.
this new comedy came out. It was like funny. It made me laugh.
Yeah. I'll have to see. I can't remember if that's the one I watched. But nice.
Yeah.
So the next one for me was Bo Burnham's Inside.
Oh,
I haven't seen that yet.
You haven't?
Awesome.
It's so good.
Is
yeah.
it?
Yeah.
Because I heard the Jeff Bezos song.
Yeah.
yeah.
And I love that song.
But yeah, he has like a lot of songs like.
I thought it was brilliant.
Yeah, it's like
it
really
like
smart.
Kind of. He's like gets to. Not, I don't know how much of it's an act and how much is it, of it is like
right.
a real thing. But like he basically has this like journey of like through depression like. Of the during like being locked down during the pandemic, and he's just in like his like room creating
content,
content or like a soundtrack or whatever. Yeah,
yeah,
just like a special.
The first,
it's a
yeah,
special.
It's
like
a yeah, it's
a
but
comedy
it,
special.
Like it's a comedy special, but it does like attack the fact that during the pandemic he was alone when he turned 30, how he was just like I had crippling panic attacks when I used to perform like in front of people, but then it's like hilarious songs like
oh it's just brilliant how like he you see him going through this because he makes it over so many days and it's almost like a vlog, but then he like also has these like really meaningful songs about like critiquing the world and stuff and it's just
yeah.
like it's like that like he's just so smart and I was just super impressed.
Yeah, the Bezos thing's really funny and then like he has one called Welcome to the Internet, which is basically like, this is what the internet has, and this is what it used to be, and this is what it's turned into. And it's like, you're like, oh, that's funny, all the funny little dirty jokes he threw in there. But it's like, yeah, that's also very true. That
yeah, that's
it.
That's
it used to be like travel blogs and chat rooms.
Yeah. I think that's the kind of the theme of the whole special is it's like, well, this is really funny and like clever, and then you're like, oh, but it's also all very like politically true and like a good message.
Yeah.
Or his message. Yeah. It's good.
Well, it's good.
Okay. So I thought it was just like music.
I mean,
it mostly is.
It's probably like 60-40 music and talking.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So that's like his, that's what his old.
But he'll just like cut to like, it's like he made like music videos for each of his songs as like the special. But in between it shows him like coming up with it and like setting up like a light. And then he's like cuts just into the thing and he's like singing and playing. And then it like cuts back and he's like, and I'm done. I'm going to go to bed now. Like, then he's sleeping. Like, I don't know. It's, like, crazy.
Yeah. And he has a song called White Woman's Instagram, and it is so funny and so accurate.
That sounds amazing.
It's, yeah, it's good. It's really good.
I remember, like, I almost was like, should I, am I liking this? And, like, not sure. And then I was like, oh, that was funny. And I'm like, what's he going to do? Like, and you're kind of, like, on this journey with him for a little bit. And then by the end, you're like, wow, that was cool. You know what I mean? So, I don't know.
The one that he had a different one on Netflix, it wasn't, maybe it was Make Happy. He had a different special. It's when he's performing, though, in like a huge theater.
Yeah.
And his finale song is like 8 minutes long, and it starts off really stupid, and it's about like Kanye West. And then it becomes about Chipotle and like stuffing a burrito, and then like the tortilla rips. And then it like, and the song, like the music is so good. And then it ends with like him talking about how he's depressed and like hopes the audience is happy because like now he's miserable, but like I hope you guys laugh tonight, and then it just ends.
I
and
saw
everyone
that.
Was like, whoa.
I think I watched that after I watched this one.
Oh, I loved that one.
Yeah,
it was so good.
It's true though. So many things right now are just like create, and like it doesn't matter, like the substance of it almost. You know, so
yeah.
He's kind of making that point. I don't know. It's good.
Massachusetts own.
Yeah.
Is he? From
yeah.
Massachusetts?
He went to St. John's Prep.
Yeah.
Wow.
Crazy.
We got the good
up
ones.
The North Shore.
Yeah.
Talented state. Watch out, Hollywood.
Yeah. You got us three.
That's yeah.
Right. All right. So I watched a movie. I think it was on Netflix, and I don't know the name of it.
What a recommendation.
I could probably look it up. But it was kind of actually along the same lines of like, basically it's about this family that lives like off the grid in like current day, and like they did it to get away from like all the political like craziness, and like have raised like kids that aren't bombarded with like the norms of today. But then they have like family members who live in society. So there's like two cousins that they go to visit, and they're like normal teenagers, American teenagers. And it's just like this whole story about how that all plays out. And
is it called Captain Fantastic?
Yes. Did you watch it?
No, but what? I know of it. Yeah.
On air. High five. Captain Fantastic. Yes. I don't know. We stumbled over it. Do you know what it was on?
I think it's on Netflix.
Yeah. I don't know. Yeah. It was interesting.
I know that Viggo Mortensen got nominated for a Best Actor at the Oscars. That's how I know of it.
Yeah.
Because so, I watched the first, like, 10 minutes, and I was like, when it came out, like, a while ago. And I was like, meh.
Yeah.
Not what I'm feeling right now.
Right. So without the spoilers, like, that's kind of the gist of it, is they're, like, they have to go and be in society for a little bit, and they're coming from a world where they like hunt and like read books, and I don't know. So it was a cool perspective, and kind of makes you realize and think about what we're actually consuming constantly versus, you know, what we would choose to if we could. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Instead of being bombarded constantly. So kind of a smart movie. It was interesting.
Is it a Netflix original?
Or I don't was this like think a so. Or is oh, it okay. Amazon?
It might be
an Amazon original.
Yeah.
Oh,
I think it is, actually. So.
Good for that.
I do what I can.
See, sometimes you just throw things
out.
Yeah,
Amazon needs to be producing movies about being bombarded about content.
Yeah.
Jeff Bezos' song. Oh, I watched, like, 3 days ago, Luca.
Ah,
you guys
yes.
have seen that, right?
We did.
Yes.
It was good.
Yeah. It's cute. Yeah.
Yeah.
I will say the end was way too easy. Like when, I don't want to spoil.
So, well, spoiler alert. Spoiler alert. Marcos, have you seen it? Oh, he's seen it. Okay.
All right.
No spoiler alert.
All right. If you haven't seen Luca, you can turn it off now.
Skip ahead. Yeah. Skip ahead. 5 minutes. Yeah. 5 minutes probably.
They bike down the hill and everyone's afraid of sea monsters. And then because they won, everyone was like,
sea monsters are cool.
They won. They can stay. Like, it was just so easy.
That's true.
Did. But wasn't it because what's her name, like, stood up for him?
Yeah, and her dad.
And her dad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was really good. I like that every time she said, like, instead of saying, like, holy crap or something, she said, like, holy mortadella. It was some sort of Italian.
Mozzarella.
Yeah. Santa mozzarella. That was it. It was like always a cheese or an Italian meat.
Yeah.
But, yeah. It's nice. Great that it was free. All right. Pixar's killing it.
I love
it.
That. Is that the end of the free Pixar drops?
I don't know.
Probably.
Maybe.
It was good while it lasted.
I did hear someone say that it's generating more people subscribing to Disney Plus by just putting them on Disney Plus. Because you're likely to sign up and be like, oh, a year is only this much, and then you have them for a year. Mm. Yeah. And then they forget about the automatic renewal, and now you got them for life.
But did you hear that Scarlett Johansson is suing Disney?
Yeah.
Because they put Black Widow on Disney Plus.
Right to Disney Plus?
It's in theaters and Disney Plus, but her contract
right now?
Said...
Yeah.
Well,
but
for
you have to
bucks.
Pay $30 on Disney Plus.
Oh.
But her contract said that she was supposed to get, like, part of her paycheck is the box office, and they said they wouldn't put it on Disney Plus.
And
they did, and she's not getting any of the income from that, I don't think.
Dang.
So she's suing them.
Wow. Yeah, I saw something. She cut ties with all.
Yep.
Luckily,
she was done
the
anyways.
Saga's over.
Yeah. So. Did I talk about the Mitchells versus the Machines?
I think you mentioned it, but, like, not really.
No, oh. I've seen that, though. What is that?
It's a Netflix original movie. It's animated.
Yeah.
And it's, like, about this family where the dad, played by Danny McBride, wants, like, one last road trip. They take their daughter to college, and he wants to, like, do stuff that's not involved with technology. And it's all about, like, a social media technology app that eventually, like, gets too smart for itself and attacks Earth. So it's like them against
it's a ride.
It's fun. It was like a fun, funny movie. I think it's Danny McBride. I thought it was Maya Rudolph. Maybe it is. Maybe she just is everyone's mom now in animated movies, but it was really good.
Oh yeah, because she was in Luca.
Yeah, she was a mom in Luca. And it I think one of the actresses from Broad Street is the main character.
Oh, yeah.
The voice of the main character.
Oh, Broad City?
Broad City, yeah.
Oh, yes, it's Abby. Abby Jacobson. See?
Nice. Got it.
I love Broad City.
Yeah, so the one that you recommended to me.
Okay.
Ted Lasso.
Oh.
Apple.
So good.
TV Plus, whatever. Original. And. The way you do we haven't talked about that on here yet. On
no, we talked just in the office
amidst ourselves.
Yeah.
The way it was pitched to me was just like a feel good show that, like, after every episode, you're like, oh, that was a great show. I enjoyed that. And you were right. I do. So he's just like a happy, like, go lucky guy who was brought to Europe, to
England
to, coach a soccer team. He's a football coach, American football, going to coach soccer. In hopes, because the owner has some whatever, the owner wants the team to fail because she got the team in a divorce, whatever.
Right. And it was her ex-husband's pride and joy.
Yeah. So she's like, I'm going to tank the team by hiring an American football coach to coach the team. But he's like this great guy and is just all about, like, the process. And he doesn't know anything about soccer, but he knows about, like, camaraderie and, like, how to, like, get people motivated and stuff. And he's hilarious. I don't know if it's a, generational thing, but he's, like, right up my alley as far as, like, the jokes and stuff.
Well, I think
he talks in, like, metaphors and puns and,
yeah,
like, all that stuff.
Jason Sudeikis is just, like, loved universally, I think.
Yeah, he's awesome.
Oh yeah, so he does a great job, and it's just a really fun, funny, lighthearted show. That, yeah, just feels good. It's good, good watch.
I need to start that one.
That's you like should, because I was like, that's kind of sounds like kind of dumb. Like he just comes and coaches, and like, but it's like so much more than that.
Yeah, it's not real. It's
not even about that.
It's a technically a sports show, but it's not.
But then you watch the last episode of the first season. I was watching like it's a sports show for a second. I even gave like a fist pump, like because they like are in the like final game or whatever. And I was like, wow, this show just got me like, usually I'm like laughing at it. Now I'm like into it, like psyched that they won or whatever. Or I don't know, whatever. So yeah, that's a good one. Ted Lasso.
Speaking of Apple TV, I watched Palmer
with
Justin Timberlake the other
night.
That's
good.
It was good. Definitely on the serious side compared to what we've just been talking about. But I thought it was actually going to be an action movie, so I was pleased that it wasn't when we started it, because my dad wanted to watch it. It was kind of the storyline that's been done a lot, but well, of like someone who lost their way, comes back home, has to move back into their old house, and is like closed off and reserved and like troubled, and then meets this little boy who lives in a trailer next door, whose mom like always just disappears because she's, I think she was like a drug addict. And he takes him in, and just like the little boy like just doesn't understand that like he wants nothing to do with him, and just like slowly breaks him down. It was cute.
I think I thought it was really good. Just there are a lot of that story that like the veteran comes home, and like there's a lot of PTSD stories. And did he have some of that?
He was in jail.
Oh, that's
right. For like 12 years. But he was like the star of the town before he went to jail.
Oh, right. He wasn't a veteran thing. Yes.
And you don't find out for like half the movie. You don't know like what happened. You just know that everyone like looks at him horribly now. But before he was like the football star.
Right. Now I'm remembering.
Yep.
But so yeah, that kind of typical story of like somebody that, you know, like you said, lost their way. But I thought the, I don't know, I feel like there's always like a love story. And this was like a dad child situation, which was a little bit refreshing, I thought. Like it was kind of a different take on like that part of it, like the second half of that kind of a story. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
The rehabilitation and what, yeah. I don't know, I thought it was cool. And the kid was awesome. He did a great job.
Yeah, he was awesome. And Justin Timberlake was awesome.
Yeah.
I'd really only ever seen him in like comedies. And I know he does dramas, but I knew him as like the Friends with Benefits guy.
Yeah.
And he was so good in this. It was a surprise.
I liked it a lot, yeah.
You mean just as an actor. You don't mean like you know Justin Timberlake from NSYNC, right?
Yes.
Okay. I was like, wait a second. Is that the generational divide on the show?
I know he sings. He had a solo album a couple of years ago.
No, he's had a few. But I was just like, wait.
Imagine
just
if
like...
I'd never heard of Justin Timberlake.
No, just thought he was an actor.
That just like hit my ear wrong. I was like wait.
I had this new up and coming actor.
Did you know he's also married to an actress? So yeah, I guess on the serious side, we'll stick with that. I recently watched Woodstock 99. It's a documentary on HBO. I've shown you like videos that The Ringer makes. Mm-hmm. They have a series coming out called Music Box, where it's like 7 documentaries about music. And this was the first one, because Woodstock 99, it was like this disaster of, it was like much like the weather is today. It was like 95 degrees for 3 straight days. There was just very poor behavior. There was like lack of security.
Jeez.
Lack of like, they were talking about how you had to pay $4 to get a water, and people like, this movie talks about how a concert goer died of hyperthermia because he overheated and all this stuff. But there was like a lot, I mean, not worse than death, but really, really bad stuff happening like within the crowd with like, just like men and women. It was really bad. And then it ended where a bunch of the people at the concert rips the staging and everything down, just lit everything on fire. And that just like happened. And it was just like a music festival with like Red Hot Chili Peppers and bands and everything. Jeez. It was just nuts. It was like when
is
you.
Is this a drama or like a?
No, it was a documentary.
Oh wow!
It like I remember it happening. Like I remember seeing it on the news.
Jeez.
I was like 12 when it happened, and yeah, it was just crazy to watch and like hear the behind the scenes stuff and how the promoters of the concert, like even today in 2021, he was like deflecting blame. He was like, "No, you have to blame the band for playing that song." And it's like that was their hit song. You had no security. It's like,
yeah.
Wait, this was Woodstock?
Woodstock 99. So they redid it 30 years later.
Okay, nice. When you just said you were 12, I was like, there's no way you were alive.
Jeez, Sarah.
You guys are not on the same page.
I was like, I thought that Woodstock was in like the 70s.
You ever heard of
it? It was in 1969.
Okay.
Yeah. You ever heard of NSYNC? They were at Woodstock, man.
I was like, either but like.
The whole thing was like, the bands they chose were like Korn and Limp Bizkit, Red Hot Chili Peppers, Kid Rock. They show, like, to start the ceremony, they brought out five dummies stacked together with the faces of the Backstreet Boys on them, and they, like, beat them with a baseball bat. And was like, what'd you expect if that's how you're starting the show off? Like, three straight days.
Dang.
And then they talked about how
Backstreet Boys were not that bad.
Right. Like,
a lot of people like them.
Like, they interview Sheryl Crow and God, I can't think of her name now. But the two women, and they were like, if you look at the schedule, there was one female act on each day. It was like, oh, we got to do this. We have to appease people by throwing them in. But if they had their choice, the promoters wouldn't even put any female acts.
Jeez.
So, like, the women came out, and it was just, like, Sheryl Crow with that, like, her hit song from that time,
yep.
Soak Up the Sun or whatever.
Right.
And it's, like, a much lighter vibe. And then the person, it's like Kid Rock follows her up, and it's like, oh, no, this is terrible. It's worth watching. It was like nuts.
Wow.
I had no idea there was a second one.
Oh, yeah. I think it was actually technically like the third one. There was another one in the 90s that was smaller.
Hmm.
Wow.
Sounds like a lot.
It was heavy. It was. But it was really good. Really well done.
Because they also had similar problems at the first one, but not as much violence. But it was like overpacked, overheated.
Yeah. And like they tore the fence down. So people just came in and didn't pay. So Woodstock 99 was on a military base because it was like walled in. They were like, this is a perfect location because we can. Right.
You can still tear the stage down.
My cousins were actually at it. I remember them going.
Wow.
Sounds scary.
Yeah.
I know. That's like Burning Man. Have you heard any of that?
Not stories. I know of it.
It's just a wild thing to like just have a.
Music festivals are crazy.
I don't even know if it's a music festival. Is it a music festival?
I think so, yeah.
Is it?
I think it might just be like a thing that people do, like live in the desert for like 2 weeks and then they burn this big
pyre.
Fire. Huge.
Oh, how about that?
I don't know.
But it's good.
That's another podcast.
Yeah.
Festivals and the ins and outs. Anyway, I might be running low here. Suicide Squad.
Nice.
Yeah, we all watched it. Yeah,
perfect. I liked it better than the first one.
Not that the
bar was very high, but
I was talking to someone and said, I think it was other than the original, the first Wonder Woman with Gal Gadot, might be the best like DC movie.
I could see that.
I think so.
I liked. I feel like the whole idea of a Suicide Squad is that they're like expendable. So like I liked how this almost leaned into it more because they had all these like other characters. They had the two teams that went in.
Hold on, wait. Marcos, did you see Suicide Squad? Yep, okay. He did.
I mean, we can avoid spoilers, but
well, it's not too much of a spoiler, but just spoiler warning. Stuff happens in the first 5 minutes you don't expect.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. But I don't know, it was just that is the point is that it's a group of expendables that they're just like taken, they don't care what happens, and they send them on impossible missions. But I don't know. I feel like they did a better job with that this time, being like, oh, this is a decoy team. Like, they're probably not going to make it. But, like, these are the people that are also there. And, like, I don't know. It was cool.
But I love that they set it up. Like, this is the Suicide Squad. Like, with Pete Davidson's character, the Weasel.
Oh, yeah.
They're, like, in there, like, they're on the poster and everything. And then 5 minutes in, you're like, oh.
Are gone.
Yeah.
That's what I mean. Yeah. It was just crazy, but that's the idea, so.
Yeah.
It was
and
cool.
The people who ended up being the main characters were way better than the characters in the first one.
Oh, yeah.
Like, they were they picked people who were, like, more likable, and you had, like, the shark was just, like, for comedic purposes.
Yeah.
And then you had, like, at least for me, like, Ratcatcher, the girl, like, was someone that you actually cared about.
As a character, right.
So they had like the nice mix, and then obviously like Harley Quinn.
I was glad Harley Quinn was in the first group and made it to the second group.
Well, yeah. That's
because I was like, wait, they're just gonna like
that was
all
what
these
was...
people are gonna.
Sorry, go ahead.
All of this whole group's gonna die, and then like, but Harley Quinn can't die, and then she made it. So I was like, all right.
Well, that was
I
just
see.
Like the genius of the story, because they were like, they put Harley Quinn with all of them, and you're like, well, they're.
Yeah,
Harley Quinn's too important.
And they
nothing's
sold
gonna,
it. With that.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. That's why I love the first like 10 minutes of it. I was watching. And I was like, what?
I know. I was confused too.
And then I was like, is this going to be a thing where now they're going to go back and tell everyone's story and it's going to be like lame? But it was like really well done.
Yeah,
and because they opened on the guy with the white long hair who plays Yondu in Guardians, and they open with him, so you think he's going to be like. The main character, because they show you him in jail and everything, and like they introduce him to the other people, and then
yeah,
it's not what happens.
It's funny that like I picked right up on that too, that it was the Marvel guy.
There's a lot of Marvel people in this.
Was there?
There was James Gunn's brother was like briefly in jail as like one of the characters who walks by and says something, but he's in like Guardians. And
oh, cool.
And someone else. Idris Elba is the guy that lets you into.
Oh yeah.
What's it called?
Yeah.
Asgard.
Right.
And then.
Oh wow! I only realized the first one. That guy.
The guy that plays Polka Dot Man is like five characters or like two. He's one of the. He's one of the guys that is
Ant-Man
in Ant-Man that's on it's like T.I. Michael Pena and then that guy from like Eastern Europe and he's the guy from Eastern Europe and then I feel like there's another one I saw but I can't remember it.
Nice.
I think Sylvester Stallone's in Guardians of the Galaxy.
Oh, the
he?
Second one, yeah.
Yeah.
And oh, he was wow. the shark.
So there's a lot of... I mean, if you make that many Marvel movies, there's only so many actors.
Yeah.
But you just reminded me. I also like that, like, they kind of knew part of this is ridiculous. Like, Sharkman, Polka Dot, like, those are, like, ridiculous. And then for the villain or whatever to be that, like, alien starfish, it was like they... I feel like in other movies or other ways, you would have been like, this is kind of dumb. I don't like it. Mm. But they were like full on, like, this is a little bit weird, but that's the story and we're going to do it well. And then they did. And like, it didn't bother me that I was like, there's just a giant starfish terrorizing the town. Mm. I mean, it was a little bit weird, but it worked.
But that's like the James Gunn thing. Cause he made the Guardians movies and it's like, those are ridiculous.
Yeah.
Like Quill's dad is a planet. Like, it's
or like when Harley Quinn jumps into the eye.
Yeah.
Oh, like, yeah. It's
like, this is like a swimming pool in there. What
I love the just like James Gunn's musical choices. It's just like it's always the perfect song.
Yeah. I just feel like if you walked into the room and that movie was on, you could easily be like, this is ridiculous.
Yeah.
And like not be into it. But when you watch it and you're like, they do a good job getting you there and it's fun.
Well, her whole side plot with the guy in, like, the palace. I was like, what is going on?
Yeah.
How does this have anything to do with anything?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That was... I also liked when Harley Quinn escaped from being detained or whatever. And then, I don't know, so many times it's like, we're going in to save her, yeah, blah, 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 blah. And she's like, oh, you're coming to save me? Like,
Do you want me to go back?
That was like the most Harley Quinn thing ever, that she was able to like get out by herself. And then like, she's not the damsel in distress. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So it was like the perfect way to do that.
I really liked the part. I think this is one of my favorite parts, where they're in the office building, like right near the big showdown. And the polka dot guy is like, oh, they got Milton. And her and Idris are like, who's Milton?
Yeah.
He's like, he's been with us for like 5 hours.
Yeah, that was funny.
And then at the end, she's like, all right, bye, Milton, to the other guy.
Yeah, and yeah, she's like, we just spent the whole day talking about it. That's your name.
Yeah, I thought it was really well done and better than the... It, you know what I liked about it? It wasn't dark.
Yes.
Like,
yeah.
Like, all the other movies are so dark and mm-hmm. bleak.
Mm-hmm. That's what I mean. It was like kind of like ridiculous and fun.
Yeah,
and done well still. So
a little bit of Marvel in there.
Yeah, maybe Marvel was onto something.
Oh, I forgot. I remember the other guy. Not Idris Elba. Taika Waititi. He was Ratcatcher, oh, and he's yeah. Korg.
Oh yeah.
Oh, did you see the after credit scene?
Yes.
It's not important. It's the weasel was alive.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Oh yeah. Yeah. That thing was weird.
That was funny.
I didn't like that.
Is this Pete Davis, is this a dog?
Yeah. That was funny.
Oh, man.
That was pretty much all my stuff.
Oh, I just had one more, but I don't think you've seen it. And it only counts because it's on Paramount Plus now, and that's A Quiet Place 2. I got a 7-day trial just to watch.
Is it free on it?
Well,
if you... pay for the service?
Yeah.
Wow. So what, you got the 7-day free trial, watched it, and...
I will be canceling that on Saturday.
Did you like it?
Oh, I loved it. It was so good.
Well done.
And then, like, they talk about the first 10 minutes is just awesome.
It's so good.
I haven't seen it yet.
Yeah. I won't tell you, but...
Thanks. So here's what happens.
Spoiler alert.
But yeah, that's it. That was my list.
We've been on a roll then.
Yeah, summer helps.
Watching a lot.
Yeah.
Vacation time.
Yeah, yeah. People on vacation. Finally, there's like actually things coming out.
Yeah.
Which is nice too.
Yeah.
It's kind of tough to go through a pandemic. And I mean, we had the time to watch shows, but we didn't have the content to like,
right, they watch weren't releasing and talk it.
About. Nothing was new. But
it's going to pick back up in like we a made month it again.
Yeah.
Like wait, the pandemic or the content?
The content.
To be seen.
I know something you guys don't know. No, because like, Dune is coming out to HBO
yeah.
soon.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Don't look up.
There's a right. day, it's like October 22nd or something, that Dune, I think, I'm not positive, but I think Dune, the new Wes Anderson movie and the new PTA movie or Edgar Wright movie are all coming out the same day.
Oh my wow. gosh.
Bring it on.
Yeah.
Give us more, that already more came to out. Talk about. Oh. I feel wow. like that was a lot of good stuff for people to watch at home.
Yeah.
That was.
You're welcome.
I have
Tune
some
in.
Stuff I need to watch now.
Yeah, I appreciate you guys giving me some ideas. Top of the list, I think, is that sketch thing.
Oh, yeah. I think you should leave. You have to watch it.
It's so good. I want to rewatch it. I actually need to see the second
yeah,
season.
Yeah, season two's out now.
Yeah.
Nice.
So we can look ahead to Stranger Things.
I would love to.
It's fun.
Because if any time there's a Stranger Things update, we're on it.
Did you get? Do you have the remote? I know you lose it all the time.
Oh, no.
Cut.
11. If you're listening. Holy mother of.
Something is coming. It is almost here.
That was it.
I should have prepared for this. I could have pulled some images.
I blame him for not having the TV set up.
All right. I gotta get.
2022. Confirmed. I'm not surprised, but at least they said it now.
That was the big takeaway for me.
Yeah.
That, and they're calling it a global phenomenon, and I feel like that's like a lot. Like
they're patting themselves on the back.
Oh, okay.
No, it takes place in Russia, some of it.
Global phenomenon. Actually, it's very good, and I'm excited for it. And I wish it wasn't 2022 because it seems so far away.
I hope it's early 2022.
Yeah, what if it's like next summer? Feels long.
Don't say that to her. Don't.
You know what I gotta do? I gotta go on Reddit and I gotta start looking at theories.
That's all you can do at this point.
Because I saw a theory. A lot of people think it's Valentine's Day. I don't know why. Oh. But I'm sure there's a reason. And I'm gonna find out for next stream it.
Wow. Good.
Don't worry. I got your back.
I have all the dirt on it. Yeah, even that trailer was. They had like stuff from all the seasons.
Yeah, and then so that wasn't like even 10 like, seconds of new ones.
Yeah. Are they in high school at this point?
I think so, but like I don't think.
They were in like middle school when it started.
Yeah, and I think third season they were like eighth grade. And I don't think.
Mall.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I don't think that they're supposed to be like a time jump or anything. So they're probably in like ninth grade.
They're going to be getting old though.
Yeah. But I think
I
it kind of
pull off the high schooler vibe.
Though. Yeah, it kind of works out though that they did like Christmas time one, and then another Christmas time one. No, then Halloween, then summer. So it's all been like condensed into like a Christmas, Halloween, and then the next summer. So it's been like a year and a half their time.
Oh.
Yeah.
Because it was like the Christmas vibe, and then the next thing was like 1984. And they had, like, the Ghostbusters and
the
malls.
And the underground. Yeah.
So.
And then they had the mall.
Yes.
With the arcade.
Yes.
And the swimming
Scoops
pool.
Ahoy.
And the Scoops Ahoy. Also an underground situation. The big elevator thing, yeah. Anyway, so we got to wait for that. That's too bad.
Yep.
Kind of.
I'll keep you updated.
On the horizon.
Yeah, it was. I feel like they hadn't acknowledged that there was a new season for like several months.
Yeah.
And people were getting annoyed because they were like, this is Netflix's biggest show. Like, why is no one talking about it?
Let's take all the previous footage and then like four new shots and give them something.
We filmed three scenes.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. But I feel like it was just nice to like get like a, okay, don't bother thinking it's coming out next month because it's not.
Right. They've probably been spending too much time on other shows.
Yeah. And Netflix. I feel like the cast was like took other jobs when Stranger
like
Things
GVK.
Wasn't. Yeah, GVK.
Yes. Right.
Because priorities. I mean, how can you not
and she's,
choose GVK?
She's done a lot of stuff recently. Did you get the whole
homes? Godzilla, King of the Monsters.
And
and the next one.
Yeah.
I think there's a third one.
Yes.
GVK Part 2.
Bring it on.
Bigger Kong.
Oh, and Max was in Fear Street. Like.
Oh, I watched the first Fear Street.
Oh, yeah, you told me.
Yeah, I like that.
Nice.
Yeah, it was good. I still have to watch the second one.
Gory.
Very gory.
So we've heard.
Sorry, man. It's right. Like Cam wants us to wrap up.
Do you want me to end it on my little review? Because I have
one. Let's hear it.
All right. It's for the Suicide Squad. I always stay in theme. Okay. 4.5 stars. This happened to a couple of my friends a few years back.
That's right. Funny.
That is funny.
We'll see you when we see you on the next stream it.
Wow.